this is Christina Dam, and this is Liberate the Podcast, where we educate, motivate, inspire, and liberate your consciousness.
I read some of it briefly and forgot all about it and would have checked it out if I knew I was talking about this today, but I didn't. So can you fill us in on like some of what you think the core message of the teachings of Mary or the Gospel of Mary Magdalene that is available right now?
Well, if you look at the words that you have, what would it be? Say we have, what, 10 different things she talks about, subjects she talks about, but it sounds exactly as we talk today. So it doesn't sound biblical at all. So it sounds like a woman who really knows what she's talking about to find your own pure self and don't find religion.
Wow.
So what we learn, what we see in the Bible and all that says we have to follow that, she doesn't do that at all. She's the opposite. She's going to go find self, love yourself. So everything is about curing yourself internally. And it's all the things we know in kind of the story we have now here.
Can you say a little bit more about who she was? Because you're saying she was a modern woman. She was a spiritual teacher. She was, you think, one of Christ's disciples. And do you think she was his wife or married to him? Or I'm just curious. What's your take?
Do you want to answer that or should we go ahead?
So many questions.
We can both answer
I don't think she was married to him because what we have people have to understand about this relationship between Mary Magdalene and Jesus, it's a love on a higher consciousness. It's a love where, because she was still also his disciple. And at the same time, he did love her more than anyone else. But I think when people try to put it in a sense of just marriage, it kind of takes away the depth of the relationship, how it's more than just what we consider, more than what earthly things are, because I think when, like, I'm not saying it's bad to romanticize the relationship.
Sure.
But I think that leaves out a big portion of the relationship where it's really about the love between, you know, God and us, and about the deep spiritualness of how what real love is.
If anybody wants to go read the Gospel of Mary Magdalene, it's been found, how do they find that?
Oh, it's pretty, you can Google it.
There's a number of
books. There's about 8 books out right now. The more recent, of course, have more information.
Okay. Are there any resources you like that you would, other than your film, which when's that coming out?
I wish I remember that. Do you remember the lady's name?
Forgot her name. It's a red book.
Oh,
it's,
there is a new book out.
Yeah, she wrote about Mary Magdalene, and then she actually uses a quotes from the Gospel of Mary Magdalene.
Beautiful.
But what she does also is that she takes some of the words from the other disciples that were not included, that basically supported what Mary Magdalene said.
What
she was. And then she does a psychology of it all together.
Yeah.
That's helpful.
So that's a new book that just came out.
Yeah.
Because it shows that this is not just, we're not just basing on Mary Magdalene's words. We're basing on, there were other, the other disciples who actually had words that supported what she was saying. So historians actually saw that they were in alignment with what was talked about, which just gives it more of that validity and credibility, which you felt was a lot of it was taken away from her.
Of course.
But we now are saying, hey, look, it's not just her saying this. The other disciples were saying what she was saying too and supporting
backing
her
up the claims.
Yeah.
They say that, and Franz says it, that she, after Jesus was crucified, the Romans went after all the other disciples and killed a number of them because they started preaching. And so they say she escaped on a boat. There are kind of paintings of her in different galleries of her in a boat. And so they say she escaped to France. And in France, she's known more than anybody. So, and they say her bones are in different churches. So also in England. So she traveled quite extensively, somewhat what they say, preaching her own masses and giving the Eucharist. And they hated that, the church hated that.
Yeah, Mary Magdalene summed up a lot of things that also Jesus also said and taught her too. So it's, I think it's very important for people to think nowadays, because I know like now strong women are coming up more prominent in mainstream media. We hear it all the time in the news and the stories we're writing. But we also wanted to point out that it's not just about this is a strong woman. This is somebody who is a very loving woman who possibly understood Jesus on a deeper level than other people did as well. And at the same time, she is a modern woman back then. And I know a lot of women nowadays would appreciate that. But we wanted to give a very fair representation of who is she, outside of the labels that people try to basically pigeonhole into that are not, that doesn't really capture who she is, or is just completely inaccurate.
I have to find you, so we'll put all the Instagram tags, but what is it? Lapis Tiger?
It's you can follow me on Instagram at lapis_tiger, because someone took my other username and I couldn't get that one. So lapis_tiger. You can contact me there, and again, you can contact the store as well to get our contact information.
Oh, thank you. I really enjoyed it.
Lapis Tiger, Alan Clancy. My name is Rebecca Muir.
Thank you.
And cheers, you guys. Have a great day.
Thank you.
Happy Divine Feminine Rising.
Yeah.
Thanks, you guys.
Bye. Thank you.
Bye.
If you enjoyed this conversation, like it, subscribe, and share it with your friends. If you want some more amazing resources on your path of liberation, head over to liberateyourself.com and sign up for our mailing list. Connect with us on Facebook, Instagram, at Liberate Hollywood, all one word, or Liberate Emporium, all one word. Until next time, liberate yourself.
Accurate.
Yeah.